So now we have MinIO running in our local environment. The next step is to actually begin some basic operations. In this section, we're going to perform basic object storage operations. This is sort of the equivalent of the CRUD, create, retrieve, update, delete loop, if you're coming from the database world. We're going to be creating objects in our local environment, listing and retrieving those objects, and then deleting those objects. There'll be a general open section towards the end where you can just experiment and try it out on your own. I already have a running MinIO deployment on my local environment, and I already have a configured alias that I can use for accessing it. The first thing I need to do is to create a new bucket. There's no buckets on this deployment yet because it's fresh. I'm going to use the following command. mcmb is the make bucket command. I'm running it against the deployment associated to the local alias, and I'm creating the data bucket. I can also do this from the MinIO console. What I've done is I've gone to my local host at the console port 9001, and I'm going to log in with the root credentials. You can see the bucket I created earlier already. I can create another bucket called data2, and that gets created automatically. So this is the same essential functionality in the console that you'll find in the CLI. Now I have a bucket. The next step is to actually copy some objects over that I've pulled from the asset pack provided as part of this module. I'm going to copy a few files over. Specifically, I'm going to use the following command. So now I've written 4 files in total, one of them to the bucket root and 3 of them to a prefix OpenSky. What the CLI is actually doing is using this PutObject API. Specifically, the MinIO CLI is acting as the application, and it's performing the PutObject API, specifying an object. And as part of the API operation, I have to specify the bucket and then the path to that object. Remember in the CLI, I wrote to both the root of the bucket and then to a prefix. I didn't have to create the prefix myself. MinIO will infer all prefixes as part of the write operation. All you have to do is specify it. So in this example, if I have /data/object1, that's the prefix. If I omit data, then it's being written to the bucket root. Now that I have some objects, I'd like to read them back. I'm going to use the following command to list all of the objects in the bucket. The mcls command is a list command. I'm using it against the local MinIO deployment on the data bucket. This returns 2 things. The first is the object in the root of the bucket, sensors.csv. The second is this 0-byte object. Well, this isn't actually an object. This is the prefix where we wrote our other data. If I rerun this against the OpenSky prefix, I can find the remainder of the files that I wrote earlier, OpenSky 1, 2, and 3. I can see something similar to the MinIO graphical console. If I go to browse, I can see sensors.csv and this prefix, OpenSky, which if I click on, will open up all of the various files at that prefix. Both the CLI and the console are doing the same thing. The ListObjects API specifically tells MinIO to return all of the objects at a specified path. If I specify the root of the bucket, I'm only going to get objects that are at the bucket root, including any prefixes. I can specify a specific prefix to limit my listing to only that prefix. MinIO will return whatever happens to be at the specified path based on what the application provides. So now I know where to find my objects. The next logical thing is to actually retrieve an object back. I'm going to use the following command. mcat, which effectively outputs the contents of the specified file to standard out. The output is the contents of sensors.csv as it is stored on the MinIO deployment. If I wanted to retrieve one of the OpenSky files, I would have to specify the full path to that file. For example, if I simply do mcat local/data/OpenSky, which is the prefix, you'll get an error back because this is a prefix and not the object itself. What I want to get is the actual file opensky1.csv. And this will return some flight data that we've parsed from the OpenSky project. The console allows me to do something very similar. I can download a file by clicking on it and then looking at the various actions that are available. If I download and open this file in something like a text editor, I'll see the same data that you saw on the CLI. Again, both CLI and console are doing exactly the same thing. The GetObject API, when provided against MinIO, will return whichever object exists at the specified bucket and path, if any. If the key doesn't exist, then the application is going to get an error back, like what we saw in the CLI. But otherwise, if the object exists at the specified bucket and path, MinIO returns that object to the application for further processing. Now, the last thing that we are going to do is actually remove a file. Specifically, let's go ahead and get rid of the sensors.csv file. I'm going to run the following command, mcrm, or remove, against the local MinIO deployment, on the data bucket, on the sensors object. And this simply removes the object from MinIO. If we return to the console, you'll note that the sensors file is now gone. The only thing left is the OpenSky prefix. And, as before, we can do the same thing here. If I click on this OpenSkies3.csv, I could hit this delete button, and it would also delete the file. And if I return to the terminal and run mcls local slash data slash OpenSky, you'll note that OpenSky 3 is now gone. This is very similar to the way that removing a file works in a file system context. Underneath the hood, this is a delete object API operation. Applications specify to MinIO the bucket and path to the object to remove. And if successful, MinIO simply removes the object and notes to the application that removal was successful. Now's a good time for you to try experimenting. Use the asset pack provided as part of this video series and try the following. Write the same file to different prefixes. Use the mcls command to explore the tree of objects at any given prefix. There's also an mctree command where you can view the full hierarchy of the bucket, and then try creating and writing to other buckets.